I'll take one.
Here you go, sir.
I say we stop this goodwill towards strangers nonsense and focus on what London really needs. Solid leadership, whose hard work will raise everyone up to success. As go the titans of business, so goes the world.
Oi, oi!
You weak fool. Get a job.
Best guards money can buy won't do Mr. Dredge any good.
Keep your eyes peeled for trouble.
By your command.
Ready to fight.
I wonder if he understands.
Keep your eyes ahead of you and walk.
Hello, hello, hello. Ugh.
Come now. You are barking up the wrong tree, sir.
I don't like the sound of that.
Shoot!
Wait a minute. I know that voice. Fry. Is that you? Fry!
What could be happening?
Is something happening?
What's going on?
Jacob, it's me, Sergeant Frederick Appeline.
Freddy.
Sergeant, undercover. There's to be a robbery at the Bank of England, I'm sure of it.
Robbery? It's a fortress.
The boys at the station thought I was joking. Wouldn't be so funny if it was their life savings.
Who's behind it?
That's confidential.
Oh, come on, Freddy. I can help you. Imagine the headlines. Thieves caught in the act. Appeline right all along.
Well, I suppose I can fill you in a little. Every fiscal quarter, a branch of the bank is robbed. Never the same branch. The thieves are supplied by Cockham merchants.
Thanks for the info, Freddy.
It's Sergeant! I'm keeping my eye on you.
If only I knew which shipment it was, then I could trace the weapons to their owner.
Capital idea, Freddy.
Here we are, the shipping docks. Now, where are the copping crates intended for Mr. Plutus? Tea. Maybe later.
Something's out there.
Hello. And now to wait for the crates to be retrieved.
Don't want them tea leaves turned to dust, do we?
Protect these crates. Any mistake will cost you dearly.
Keep your knickers on. We hear ya.
Good, because I ain't repeating myself.
It's a shame I can't stop in for a pint.
Oh, fog.
I bet Greenie's tailing Evie right about now. Good luck. Templars. Ah, yes. Lead me to Mr. Plutus.
up there.
Templars. Ah, yes. Lead me to Mr. Plutus. Templars. Ah, yes. Lead me to Mr. Plutus.
Same routine as before. The Twopenny opens a vault, we robs it and leaves the money in his storehouse. Look sharp, the boys are waiting.
To the Bank of England. Yeah.
Plutus is Twopenny.
Well, what say you?
You're not gonna like it.
Now, see here. I am graced with the Abilene family's robust constitution.
Two pennies robbing the Bank of England.
The governor of the bank. I think I might need to sit down.
There's no time for that. Bastard's probably deep in the vault by now.
However you get in, I don't want to know.
Of course. But do you know how I can get in?
The bank is designed to protect England's gold reserves. A fortress, guarded under lock and key. There is the bank manager, Mr. Osborne. Only he is allowed free access to the vault. You can spot him near the entrance. And, oh yes, one man keeps a close watch on the vault door. He watches it like a hawk. If he sees you, he's sure to see it. The guard captain, Gus Howard, knows Twopenny well. He is in on this, I'm certain. Mr. Fry, please use discretion. The only way to implicate Twopenny is to catch him in the act. Do not jeopardize him. No big displays. This is the Bank of England. If you encounter any trouble, I'll be in the atrium. In disguise.
Twopenny won't be leaving that vault.
How are things?
Just that it's still with us.
I wonder if I know this ball play.
Oh, this one's brown bread.
I'm your man if you need me.
Last chance to join our group and learn of the great wonders of the bank.
I've got the eye on that chap. Now you stop that, young man!
Fitting for Two Pennies 2.
He's not up to any mischief.
Where is Tupini?
Please! I have a family. He's in the vault ogling his priceless paintings.
Oh no!
Count on me.
Stretch him out!
I'll cover your back. Just my luck.
What are you up to?
Of the banking world.
Oh, goodness!
for your time.
Has everyone assembled?
Enjoy
yes.
the day.
Yes.
I will let the governor
Excellent.
Know how helpful
I shall
you will
begin
be
the
when
talk.
Next we dine.
We start in the pay hall, the bank's center of activity.
I'll back you up if you're in any bother, Jacob.
I'm your man if you need me.
Shh. He's
hiding. What's
going
on down? Funny thing to do in the middle
of the
night.
Not much of a hiding spot if we can see him.
Huh? Huh?
Get a load of this. Still, this is London.
Take you in, and you'll see everything is perfectly secure.
You've had enough to drink.
I wonder if I'll know the poor beggar.
Yeah, at least you're out of this stink, ain't you?
I'm here if you need me, Jacob.
I'll carry you back.
Jacob.
Rest of your life to count it, as long as you live.
Thank you.
you'll get your cut as promised.
We'll be rich.
Damn your clumsiness!
Sorry, sir. It won't happen again.
You've stolen your last shilling from the people of London.
Those animals squander their savings. We are the experts in investment. Nothing would be built or improved. Nothing would rise above the muck without our hand guiding. No creating the future. They benefit as much as their worth.
It is their city, not yours.
Without our investments, there would be no city.
For the path of the dead.
I thought he came up.
He's not rusted, as you were.
He's our problem.
Leave you dry.
Ready, fire. I've got him in my head.
Throw everything you have at him! I'll eat your eyes!
Get away, you rat!
Bring him down!
Thank goodness, the police! We're saved!
Arrest them all for robbing the people of England. The Bank of England is closed until further notice.
The currency, a laughingstock. Inflation out of control, twopenny brutally murdered.
And yet Parliament does nothing.
The bill will be defeated, sir. That buffooned Israeli shall be taken care of. It has been arranged, upon my honor.
Your honor carries little weight.
How dare you, sir!
The poor people of this city have suffered enough. Today I granted a significant rise to my staff in order to counter inflation.
What?
I would supply all of London if I could. Meanwhile, you sit in your club and wax poetic with promises your honor cannot pay. Your family's fortune, however. I wonder what they would offer to keep your record out of the newspapers. About the same as Disraeli would offer for your balls, I'd wager. But let's be generous. Why limit ourselves to one or the other, when we can have it all? What say you, sir? Shall I come collect? No more dallying. The halls of Parliament must be free to govern. Again! Understood? You may see yourself out.
A letter? For me?